My friend, today new lecture, trauma and traumatism. With you, Professor Christian Valery, General Surgery Department. We begin. Traumatology is a science about traumas. Orthopedics, orthostraight, pedi baby, Greek ancient name is a science about recognition and treatment of development disorders, injuries and diseases of the musculoskeletal system and their complications. Trauma. Trauma, injury, ancient Greek, is the instant influence of the external factor which causes in the tissue local anatomic and functional disorders which are accompanied with general reactions of the organism. That's definition. Traumatism. Traumatism is a constant set of injuries in a certain area, in the country, city, some regions, geographical definition, etc. Or among a certain contingent of people in agriculture, in industrial, sports, production, etc. Types of traumatism. Production, industrial and agricultural. Injuries of the way to and from work. Next, non-occupational injuries, road, transport, street, sport, children, household. Another one, criminal, intentional, and military. Classification of injuries. All damages by the mechanism of the occurrence are divided into direct and indirect, depending on the ratio of the place of damage and the point of application of the force. Next, there is a division into superficial or cutaneous bruising wound, subcutaneous rupture of ligament, muscles, dislocation, fracture, cavity injuries, ruptures or concussion of internal organs. Next, depending on the preservation of the superficial tissue, all injuries can be closed or open. Next, damage to muscular skeleton system, which is combined with the damage to internal organs, parenchymatal ones, mostly, is usually called a combined injury or polytrauma. When the influence of a mechanical factor is combined with any other, frostbite, for example, radiation, burns, etc., we talk about combined injuries. When considering any damage to the musculoskeletal system, the most appropriate is the determination of the following sections: closed soft tissue injuries, dislocations, fractures. Closed soft tissue damage, contusion. Contusion, contusio in origin, is the closed mechanical damage to soft tissue and organs without visible violation of other anatomical integrity. Closed soft tissue damage, contusion, we know the considering mechanism of development, such as a contusion is usually the result of a fall from a small height or a hit inflicted by a blunt object with the low kinetic energy. It's principle because it depends on the result of the damages. Closed tissue damage, contusion, clinical features. The main clinical manifestation of a contusion are pain, swelling, I mean edema, hematoma, and dysfunction of the damaging organ. Close soft tissue damage, contusion, clinical picture in a progress. The time of manifestation of hematoma, hemorrhage, depends on its depth. When the skin and subcutaneous tissue are contused, the hematoma becomes visible almost immediately. Imbibition, skin infiltration, intradermal hematoma, very indicative, showable. With a deeper location, the hematoma may appear on the outside as a bruise only on the second, third days, not earlier. The color of the bruise changes due to breakdown of hemoglobin. Fresh bruise is red, then its color turns red, and after 3 days it turns blue. Some changes visible after 5-6 days, and the bruises become green, then yellow, and then gradually disappear. We now considering the some changes from the first until 7 days. Thus, the color of the bruise can determine the age of the damage and the terms and the time of the occurrence, which is especially important in forensic examinations also. Lesion of the function in case of contusion usually does not occur immediately, but it may appear as the hematoma and edema increase. At the same time, there are restrictions in active movements which are connected with the expressed pain syndrome and lessen the physical activity as well. Passive movements can be maintained, although they are also very painful. This distinguishes contusions from fracture and dislocations, in case of which movement disorders occur immediately after the injury, and disorders are typical for both active and passive movements. To reduce the development of hematoma and traumatic edema, could should be applied locally as early as possible. To achieve this, a bubble of ice is applied to damage area and is desirable to keep it for 12-24 hours during the whole day with breaks every 2 hours for 30-40 minutes. Ice bag we must change this period of time. In case of sports injuries, chlorothiazide is sprayed on the skin in the area of the damage for the same purpose, like an example of terminal anesthesia. In the limbs is damaged, it can be placed under cold running water, bandaged with a wet bandage. To reduce movement in the joints in case of contusion, a compressive bandage is applied as soon as possible from the moment of the injury. The time is matter in this way. And to reduce edema and elevated position, the limb may be used. Though providing functional immobilization, so-called. Starting on the second, third day, thermal procedures, hot water bottle, UIHF therapy are used to accelerate hematoma resorption and eliminate edema. In some cases, the formation of large hematomas is located especially deep, a puncture is made, and then a compressive bandage is applied. Method of cure. Evacuation of such hematomas is necessary due to risk of the infections, purulent hematoma, suppurator process as well, or its organized hematoma. In case of contusion, significant detachment of subcutaneous tissue is also possible, which usually leads to to accumulation of serous fluid and requires repeated puncture and compression depth. Close soft tissue damage distortion definition. Distortion, distorsio, is the tissue damage with partial rupture while maintaining anatomical integrity. Next, mechanism of development. Distortion usually occurs with a sharp sudden movement. The mechanism of the injury is the impact of forces in opposite direction or created by the action of force on a fixed organ limb. The ligaments of the joints are most often damaged, especially the ankle or knee when the foot is sprained. The clinical picture is a case of distortion is similar to contusion with the location of the field of joints. There is also pain, swelling, hematoma, and joint dysfunction, lessened function as well, is even more pronounced than in case of contusion. It's more cases than the trauma of the softened tissue. Treatment is to cool the area of the damage and apply a pressure damage to reduce range of motion and prevent the growth of hematoma. Since the third day, thermal procedures are started and gradually loading is restored. Rupture. Rupture is a close damage to tissue of organs with the violation of the anatomical integrity. There are rupture of ligaments, muscles, and tendons. Mechanism of development. Mechanism of rupture and distortion are similar. But in case of rupture, a sudden strong movement or contraction of the muscle leads to distortion of the tissue, which exceeds the barrier of elasticity, that's causing a violation of integrity of the organ. Ligament rupture clinical features. Ligament rupture most often occurs in the ankle or knee joints, as I mentioned before. At the same time, the expressed pain, hypostasis, and the hematoma, and also considerable restriction of function of a joint are observed. Ligament rupture of the knee joint is often accompanied by the development of gematrosis, especially with the damage to the intra-articular ligaments, cruciate. The presence of blood in the joint is determined to be a symptom of bulging of the patella covering in the joint with the hands, with the thumbs of both wrists pressing to the patella and palpating the spring of each displacement, as well as radiography, X-ray, expansion of the joint space. Can be used by the MRT or so. Treatment the ligament rupture. Cool during the first day and provide rest. Resting is the prior priority, it's a first principle. Providing the functional immobilized resting. To do this, use a tight bandage and in some cases the imposition of a plaster splint, cast, applying the cast on this area and providing the immobilized this field. Careful movement should be started second, third weeks after the injury, gradually restoring the load. In case of hematrosis, a puncture of the joint is performed with the evacuation of the blood in the joint, and this is a QA moment, you know. With the accumulation of blood in the future, puncture may be repeated, but this is rarely needed. After the puncture, a plaster splint is applied for 3 to 2 weeks to provide immobilization, and then rehabilitation is started. Muscle rupture are usually observed in case of excessive load on them, the impact of gravity, rapid strong contraction, a strong hit to the contracted muscle. If injured, the person feels severe pain, after which there is swelling on hematoma in the area of the rupture, muscle function is completely lost. The most common rupture are the rupture of the quadriceps femoris, calf muscle, biceps brachii. Clinical picture and treatment. There are incomplete and complete muscle rupture. It's divided. In incomplete rupture, hematoma, severe pain and area of injury. Treatment usually consists of cooling first day, resting in position of muscle relaxation for 2-3 weeks, plaster splint. Since the third day, it is possible to carry out physiotherapeutic procedures. At repeated injuries, sport trauma, treatment can be longer, and rehabilitation too. A distinctive feature of complete rupture is the palpation of the defect, failure, sinking, so-called, in the muscle, in the affected area, which is associated with the reduction of the rupture tense of the muscle. A hematoma is determined at the area of the defect. Treatment of complete rupture, surgical. The muscle are sutured, after which immobilization is required in the position of relaxation of the sutured muscle for the 2-3 weeks, maybe more, plus the bandage. Restoration of function and loadings is carried out under the control of the methodologist and medical physical education. The mechanism of tendon rupture is the same as muscle rupture. Tendon torn rupture usually occurs either at the site of the attachment to the bone or at the junction of the muscle and the tendon. The most common rupture are the ruptures of the extensor tendons or the fingers, Achilles tendon, long head of the biceps brachii. When the tendon is ruptured, patient complaint is moderate pain, there is a local pain and swelling in the tendon, complete lesion of the function of the corresponding muscle, flexion and extension, but passive movement. Treatment of tendon rupture is operative. The tendon are sutured with the special suture, after which 2-3 weeks immobilization is performed with the plaster bandage in the position of relaxation of the corresponding muscle, and then gradual rehabilitation is started. And lasting maybe several months. Only in some cases when the extender tendon of the hand extends, conservative treatment is possible, mobilization in the extension position. In more short terms. Concussion, commotio, is a mechanical impact of tissue which leads to a violation of the functional state without obvious anatomic definition. Dislocation, luxatio, is a stable, complete displacement of the articular ends of the bones, in which the possibility of collision of the articular surfaces is lost. There are also subluxation, incomplete displacement of the articular. Dislocations can be congenital or acquired. This division is largely conditional, as among the congenital deformities of the main importance if congenital hip dislocation, which in a sense is a violation of development of hip joint. The vast majority of dislocations are dislocation acquired, or rather traumatic and pathological dislocation, dislocation of the joint surfaces due to the disease, tumor, tuberculosis, osteomyelitis, and so forth, are rare and are usually considered as a joint form of the disease. In ancient times, dislocations were divided into fresh up to the 2 days, non-fresh up to the 2-3 days, and old more than 3-4 weeks. Irreversible dislocations are dislocations in which there is an interposition of the soft tissue, and which cannot be corrected without surgery. Typical dislocations are persistent, recurrent of dislocation that occurs after the initial dislocation in the joint. The most common is the usual dislocation of the shoulder and knee slide. Dislocation usually occurs due to indirect injury, falling on an extended or bent limb, or hit with a fixed limb, as well as due to excessive muscle contraction. The peripheral part of the limb relative to the central is considered dislocated. Dislocation in diagnosis in the presence of the following elements: history of the injury with a characteristic mechanism, pain syndrome, deformation in the area of the joint and change in the axis of the limbs while the joint end may be palpable or may be visible to the eye in an unusual place for him. Forced specific for each dislocation position of the limb, and change limb length, often shortening. Next, lack of active and sharp restriction of passive movement in the joint, sprint fixation during passive movement when trying to remove to the limb from the forced position. There is elastic sprain resistance, and then it again takes the forced position, and mandatory X-ray examination. For the diagnostic in the second position. The first aid in case of dislocation consists of transport immobilization and introduction of analgetic and painkiller at the expressed pain syndrome. To correct the dislocation, the injured person should be taken to the trauma center or the reception room of the hospital, which has a regular trauma service, as soon as possible. Correction of dislocation should be performed by a specialist, traumatologist or surgeons on duty. Dislocation correction is much easier with a smaller damaged joint and the less time since the dislocation. The time is matter everywhere, my friend, because more earlier, more good result. Better result connected with the earlier diagnostic and earlier treatment. Indications for surgical treatment of dislocations are open dislocations, irreducible fresh dislocation, I mean soft tissue interposition, old dislocations, and typical dislocation. The essence of surgical treatment is to eliminate the dislocation and strengthen the ligament and capsules of the joints. At surgical treatment concerning typical dislocation, special plastic operation or joint capsule, ligaments and the sinews with the use of both local and allogenic fabrics are used. Immobilization and rehabilitation of dislocation. After the dislocation is reduced, immobilization is performed for an average 2-3 weeks. To do this, plaster bandage or splint are used. After a few days, then can be replaced with a shoulder or other method of mild immobilization. In 1-2 weeks, with the preservation of soft immobilization, gradual movement in a joint begin, of course, of medical physical training should be performed. Full recovery occurs after 30-40 days, and the possibility of the full loads is achieved within 2-3 months or more. Fractures definition. Fracture is a violation of the bone integrity. Classification by origin. Fractures are divided into congenital, prenata, and acquired. This division, however, is not accurate because during the development of the fetus, fractures and abnormalities and malformations usually do not occur. Fracture that occurs during childbirth, during the passage of the fetus, are called obstetrics fracture, and they are type of acquired one. All acquired fractures by origin are divided into two great groups, traumatic and pathological. Traumatic fracture occurs at the first in the intact bone when the force of mechanical impact is so high that it exceeds the strength of the bones. Another one, pathological fractures, occur under the influence of much less force, sometimes when turning in bed, etc., which is associated with the previous bone lesions pathological process. Melanin tumor, metastasis, endocrinal diseases, tuberculosis, osteomyelitis, decrease bone strength in hyperparathyroidism or so, etc. By the presence of the damage of the skin, fractures are divided in the open and closed. Fractures that occurs without damage to the skin and mucous membrane are called closes. They make up the majority of the fracture of peacetime. In the presence of damage to the skin or mucous membrane in which the wood connected with the fracture site, the fracture are called open. A distinctive feature of open fractures is the appearance of an entrance gate for the infections, with the possibility of further development of the osteomyelitis and other infections, complications, pyogenic process or so. A special group consists of gunshot fractures. The feature is massive damage to bones and forced tissue. Arterias, veins, nerves are open damages. By the nature of the bone, damaged fracture can be complete or incomplete. When the fracture extends to the entire diameter of the bone, the fracture is called complete. They are more common. If the fracture surface does not pass through the entire diameter of the bone, the fracture is called incomplete. Incomplete fractures include cracks, subcutaneous fracture, or in children like a green twig type, classical in a teenager. In the direction of the fracture line, there are transverse, oblique, longitudinal, fragmentary, helical, knocked, compression, and detachable fractures. In this case, each type of fracture is usually corresponding to the specific mechanism of the injury. Thus, a helical fracture occurs when the limb is twisted. Its rotational motion when the proximal and distal parts are immobile. Detachable or open fracture occurs with excessive contraction or tension of a particular muscular group. Compression with a strong action along the axis. A lot of mechanism, like here in these images, you see classification of bone fracture. A, it means transverse. B, oblique. C, helical. D, fragmentary. And double in and more places. Classification, depending on the presence of the placement dislocations of bone fragmentar relative to each other. Fractures can be without displacement and with displacement. Next, displacement of bone fragmental can be in width, ad latum in Latin, in length and longitudinally, at the angle and axis, and rotation, peripheral terminology. Types of displacement of bone fragmental: A, at the angle; B, in the width; C, rotary; D, in length. You can see in these images and with the arrows that indicative of destination and the movement towards the each other, you know, and see there like a fragment of the please see fractures classification, including the depending on the part of the damages. Bone fractures can be diaphyseal, metaphyseal, and epiphyseal. Diaphysis, metaphysis, and epiphysis. They are old Greek terms, but it works until the modern time recently. It should be noted that epiphyseal fractures are almost like an intra-articular. By number of fractures, there are single or multiple. Next point. According to the complexity of the damage to the musculoskeletal system, there are simple or complex fractures. Simple fractures are those in which the integrity of only one bone is compromised. If a fracture of two bones occurs in the area of the injury, or the fracture is accompanied by its dislocations, rupture of ligamentum, capsules of the joints, those fractures are called complexes one. For example, a fracture of both forearm bones with the displacement or ankle fracture with detachment for the posterior edge of the tibia with the subluxation of the foot is a complex fracture. Due to this, very difficult to cure this, and the rehabilitation time consume more than in a simple one, like a half a year or maybe more. Depending on the development of the complications, there are uncomplicated and complicated fracture. Possible complications of fracture: traumatic shock, damage to internal organs, pneumothorax with rib fracture, multiple rib fracture, brain damage with the skull fracture, etc. Next point: damage to blood vessels, bleeding, pulsating hematoma, and rupture of nerves, fat embolism, wood infections, osteomyelitis, sepsis as well. In case of a combination of fractures with injuries of the another nature, we can speak about the combined injury of polytrauma. Examples of the combined injury: fractures of the tibia on both extremities and the rupture of the spleen, like an example. And with example such a fracture of the shoulder, dislocation in the hip joint, and the contusion of the brain. More and more absolute symptoms of fracture. Symptoms are called absolute if the detection of at least one in the symptoms indicates the presence of the fracture. There are three absolute fracture symptoms. First, typical deformation. Typical deformational is a change in the configuration of the limbs, as well as in cases where you can visibly see the displaced bone fragments. Next, pathological mobility, presence of movement outside the joint area, where the mobility in a normal anatomical structure must be visible. Bone crepitus, a typical crunch of a correspondent palpatory sensations that occur with the bone fragments are moved against each other. In a normal situation, it's not be. Look, it looked like here in the images. See the shows. Diagnosis. Relative symptoms of fracture. Symptoms are called relative if the detection in on which only in the aggregate indicated the presence of the fracture. Relative fracture symptoms. Pain in the area of the injury. Hematoma in the area of the injury. Deformation of the limb in the area of the injury. Shortening of the limb. Forced position. Dysfunction. We can evaluate the absolute and relative symptoms and after that examples of radiographs or clavicular fractures, as you see. You see on X-ray, it looks like clavicular fractures with a serious distortion of the bone. Disconnection, dislocation. Fracture of the third metacarpal bone in the left hand, you see. Metacarpal bone on the left hand, you see very vividly the line of the fracture and of the bones. Treatment of the fracture. Creation of the necessary condition for fracture union can be achieved in a different way. There are three main methods of the treating fracture. First, conservative treatment, closed repositional, and immobilization with a plaster or a cast bandage. Next, skeleton traction, surgical treatment, osteosynthesis. These types of treatment are carried out of the stage of providing quality care. The treatment of the injured person begins with the first aid. First aid is the most important link in a treatment in the whole process of the fractures. Rendering first aid helps prevents complications such as shock, bleeding, infections, and additional displacement of the fragment. In this regard, first aid includes the following measure. Stop bleeding, shock prevention, painkiller and so drugs, transport immobilization, and application of the aseptic. Stop bleeding. In the presence of the pre-hospital bleeding, the compression bandage is more often used to temporarily stop it, and tourniquet and compressive bandage. Next, prevention of shock. Prevention of shock should be carried out in all cases when the mechanism of injury and the solutions and the multiple fracture, polytrauma or so. Pre-hospital anti-shock measures in addition to stopping bleeding, including the analgesia, administration of plasma replacement solution or so. Transport immobilization, callousness during transfer and transportation causes sharp pain and displacement of the fragments. While lifting the injured person, you need to hold the fragmenter with your hands and pull the limb lengthwise for the less displacement. Transport immobilization reduces the patient's impact on the adverse effect of the fracture. New method of transport immobilization, including the auto mobilization, bandaging the injured person's lower limb to a healthy or upper limb to the torso, immobilization with the help of improvised means, improvised spleen, the using stick, boards, pieces of the plywood or skis, cardboards, umbrellas, etc. as a hard object to which the damaged limbs can be fixed. Immobilization will be with the standard transport splints is the best way of the transport immobilization. The main types of transport splint for fracture: Kramer type, due to the possibility of modern modeling, it has become widespread in case of injury of the upper and lower extremities, head and neck. Jelanski splint is used for head and neck injuries. And the modern recent years, widespread and pneumatic splints have been widely used for injuries for lower leg and forearm. The Dietrich splints are used for the lower limb injuries, but its application and aseptic bandage. It's clear, you understand, if used for any damages to the integrity of the skin, if it means preventing secondary infections. Individual dressing bag and sterile dressing, you can. Conservative treatment of fracture. Conservative treatment, closed reposition, after that immobilized with the plaster cast. The method it used for simple closed without significant displacement or fragment, and too easy eliminated it, simple fractures of the tibia, forearm, for example, fingers or so. You see immobilization with a plaster bandages on this image. It look like here. And maybe it's all enough for today. Other prolonged lecture, and we have proceed in another time. Thanks for here. It's all for today. My friend, we have to proceed with a pleasure. Next images. Skeletal traction. It's the second principal method of the treatment of fracture. You can see on this picture how this device works. You understand the very complex construction. But it account on the relax of the muscle, and take more time than other methods, but more physiological, because gradually, slow, step by step, relaxation muscle, and in this way. The consolidated fragment of the bone and forming the callous tissues on the spot of the fracture. You can see one and second picture how it works. Good method, but takes a lot of time. But physiological one. Surgical treatment of fractures. Surgical treatment includes two techniques. First, classical osteosynthesis, and second, extrafocal compression, distraction osteomyelitis. And both methods very good works. And maybe in some cases they combined. with combination they work. Surgical treatment of fractures. A. Classical osteosynthesis. In case of the classic surgical treatment of a fracture, with the help of the surgery, an open one-step manual reposition is performed. This allows, in each case, to achieve a perfect comparison of fragments and consolidate it, despite of the complex nature of the displacement. And this is works quickly, because it fixated in the proper position, and the calloused tissues started working since first hours. Immobilization is mainly provided by various metal structures. When the structures are located inside the bone marrow canal, osteosynthesis is called intramedullary, and when the structures are located on the bone surface, they are called extramedullary. His place in the surgical assortment of the treatment. B. Extrafocal compression distraction osteosynthesis. Basic principles. The extrafocal compression distraction osteosynthesis, spokes are made in different planes through the proximal and distal fragments outside the fracture area. The spokes are fixed on the rings or other elements of the outer structure of a special device. Could have a good recommendation in a former USSR and have an invention in our former country and have an author's name by Apparatus Ilizarov, Gudushauri, etc. Ilizarov compressed and distraction device. You see the devices and a lot of spokes, and this construction with a four rings, they connected with each other the metal construction, and it works logically too. Distraction millimeter by millimeter, gradually, inconsequently, consistency, they substituted the new bone tissue. Compression syndrome or a crash syndrome, accident, catastrophe is a kind of pathological condition caused by prolonged more than 2-4 hours compression of soft tissue. A disaster in the in a wartime, in a quake, earthquake, and weather situation related to the ruins that must exclude the patients from the ruin, from the heavy way. Pain impulses, traumatic toxemia, plasma and blood loss are important in the development of the crash syndrome. There are three periods in a clinic course. First, increase in edema and vascular insufficiency, first days, lasting maybe 1, 2, 3, maybe a little more days. Excuse me, 1 minute. Да-да. Говори, говори. А, как занято? В смысле, ты с ней договорился? А, 4 дня. Она мне сказала, что... Ну, давай я перезвоню, уточню. Странно, я с ней говорил, она ждет звонка. А как вы договаривались? Ну, ладно, хорошо. Чуть... А ты сказал ей, да? А. Ну да, скажи, что от меня, и что там проплатят же все, скажи. Уточни пусть, давай, ага, а то я сейчас на видеоконференции, добро. There are three periods in the clinical course. Increase in edema vascular insufficiency, I repeat. And second, acute renal failure, 3-14 days. Lasting and convalescence. Or treatment. Immediately after the extremity is released from compression, an elastic bandage and the transport splint are applied to slow down the flow of toxic products into the bloodstream and anti-shock measures, painkiller and so I administered administration of narcotic analgetic, transfusion of plasma replacement solution, the stabilized arterial pressure, and so forth. Upon admission to the hospital, a powerful detoxification therapy is prescribed. Local wound treatment, primary necrectomy, debridement of the wound is carried out. Conducting the novocaine blockade is performed. And it is important to create hypothermia during the first 1-2 days. If needed, the limb is removed the organ but saving life. War-related surgical injury. A gunshot wound in the damage to tissue and organs with the violation of the integrity of their cover. Mostly skin, mucous membrane or serous membrane. Caused by a war-related surgical prolonged. Factors of gunshot wound formation. A. The main shock wave, the impact of the tissue of direct impact and compressed air. B. Lateral shock wave, a temporary pulsating cavity that acts on the tissue around the wound canal. C. The direct effect of the projective on a live tissue. And D. Vortex trace, the flow of air at tissue particles behind the projective, which further injure the tissues after exposure to the projective. You see on the images like it looks, the wound channel and the rupture of the muscle and the gunshot prime canal and the lateral shock wave cavity. On these images you can see the structure of the firearm injury. The first zone, coaxial wound canal as a result of direct destruction of tissue by the projectile. Second zone, contusion of primary traumatic tissue necrosis around the wound canal. And third zone is the zone of concussion of molecular shock or the zone of secondary necrosis. On these images you see the entry in the left corner, the entries of the bullet or other object, moving object, the zone of the actual wound canal, and the second you can see the contusion of primary traumatic tissue necrosis, and the third one, the zone of concussion, molecular shock, molecular shape. Visual characteristic of firearm wound. The size of the inlet entrance and the outlet exit holes of the wound canal can be determined by the type of projectile. In case of injuries by a supersonic small caliber bullet, the outlet is larger than the entrance. It's the peculiarities. You can take into account this specific. Next, in case of arrow-shaped bullet wounds, the entrance hole corresponds in size to the exit hole. And the third point, with the injuries from the shrapnel or rubber balls, the inlet is larger than the outlet. Into consideration this specific. On the left images you can see the gunshot fracture in the fibial bone. You see the fragments of the bones deviation, and in the middle images the gunshot fracture with the bullet such a caliber you can see. And the deviation of the fragmentation of this fragments of the bone. And the right corner, the gunshot fracture, the maybe the such a this caliber, and the with of bone. Type of primary surgical treatment of firearm wounds. A. Early up to 20 hours, 12 hours after injury. Delayed from 12 to 24 hours after injury. And late, later than after injury. Indications for primary surgical treatment of firearm wounds. A. Penetrating gunshot wounds to the skull, chest, abdomen, large joints, eyeball. B. Bleeding from the wound, continuing bleeding. C. Gunshot wounds of long tubular bones, large main vessels and nerve trunks. D. That threatening immediately to the life. Wounds contaminated with toxic radioactive substances and grounds. And E. Wounds with massive soft tissue damage. All this and immediately threatening to life may be lead to the serious consequences and negative complications. Contraindications for primary surgical treatment of firearm wounds. A. Tangential point, so-called dotted, in other words, through the and blind soft tissue injuries with a small diameter of the inlet and outlet openings throughout. B. Injuries without damage to large vessels and nerves. C. Injuries that do not penetrate into the body cavity and any cavity. D. Injuries that are not accompanied by gunshot fracture of the bone except for the so-called perforated fractures. And E. Injuries that are not accompanied by significant contamination. So be considering like a conventional fresh wound. Stages of the primary surgical treatment of firearm wounds. A. Dissection of the wound to turn it into the linear form. It's more convenient to the surgical manipulation and scar forming. B. Stop bleeding. It's ultimately rule. Removal of foreign bodies and site object, hematomas, free bone fragments. D. Transfer of a complex wound into a simple one. Very good rule, and for surgery is principle. E. Excision of non-vital edges of the wound, necrotic tissue, and so forth. And F. Wound drainage. Wound drainage is mandatory because the accumulated maybe even serous liquid may be after some time contaminated and transform and turn out to be and created a more problem. This gather concreted can create the serious problem furthermore. Ways of drainage of wound in case of gunshot injuries. C. Like settle the drainaging and with a great caliber diameter that must work and removing and exudate through drainage of the wound cavity. Wood drainage by double lumen primary surgical treatment drainage, you see. Double lumen drainage, how it works. And in one entries you can irrigating the antiseptic antibiotics, and in other drainage it must be works like dialysis, washing. Flow flushing drainaging, you see the third image how it works. Flow flushing, they're providing dialysis, pyogenic, and that is all, my friend. Thank you for your attention.